This is the climactic scene from Steven Spielberg's Close Encounters of the Third Kind. It's the moment the whole film has been leading up to, and it doesn't disappoint. It is truly stunning. A practical special effect that over 40 years later still has the ability to inspire a sense of awe and wonder. To me, it's the perfect implementation of a special effect because it complements the film rather than overwhelms it. And in the case of Close Encounters, it is merely prelude to the scene that truly encapsulates what this magical piece of cinema is really about. The film's lead protagonist is Roy Neary, played by Richard Dreyfuss, but he's not, as far as I'm concerned, where the film's heart lies. That is in the character of Claude Lacombe, played by François Truffaut, who took the role as he was writing a book about acting and wanted to get some more experience. We don't know really all that much about Lacombe's background other than he's head of the French side of whatever this project is. We know that contact has been made of an alien race, and the two civilizations are in some form of dialogue, yet the film never explicitly states what it is they are talking about. It's a mystery, the suspense of which is slowly building throughout the film. And let's be honest, the aliens' behaviour is slightly worrying. They don't seem overtly hostile, but we all know abduction is bad. But when you're running off with kids in the night, you have to wonder what goes on their homeworld. Why the character of Lacombe so fascinates me is because he's not the scientist spouting mumbo jumbo. Indeed, he can barely speak English. And Truffaut has his Gaelic charm, resembling a slightly better looking version of a science teacher you had at secondary school. And indeed, the film has an everyman quality to it. Roy is a blue collar worker with a family embroiled in something beyond any human's comprehension. He could be us. And Lacombe, despite not having the answers, has something far more compelling: questions. So after the aliens have told us where they will land and Roy has been whisked off, we get to the scene that truly, for me, makes Close Encounters. A lone alien approaches Lacombe, and I have a theory as to who it is. This is his alien counterpart, and it is whom Lacombe has been in communication with. And this is the moment the pair finally get to meet. And it's Spielberg at his best. What has happened before may have been epic, but he has managed to encapsulate the awe and wonder of the film in such a simple, beautiful moment. Both alien and human simply stare at each other in wonder. The alien even cocks its head, seemingly trying to fathom what it is seeing. And then, of course, there is the exchange. The sign language, with the wonderful cut from over the shoulder to his hand, revealing him to be the ever professional scientist he is. And the alien responds in kind and then wonderfully smiles back. The pair have done it. And it's why I love Close Encounters. It is a feel-good science fiction film that is rarer in the genre than it should be. And it was Spielberg at the peak of his powers. It has wonderful practical special effects, with each character perfectly cast, and along with a beautiful John Williams score, all combining to deliver an experience that only Hollywood can.